first thesis. Without the teaching of reincarnation, you will never come to a good educational system. Who of you? I agree with the thesis. When I was 35, that there were came big changes in my life. I had to think deeply about all things. I recently sang a song for a colleague of mine, also became 35. Yes, 30 colleague, at 35 I'm busy with making my future plans. So I agree with the thesis. Is it interesting with this thesis? What in history have been in society where reincarnation was really an important thought? Or in societies where this idea of reincarnation was not important, and what the results were? We have done such type of analysis already in the past. Of the last 2 days, are you of the opinion that you should take the concept of reincarnation, that a good educational system should be based on the thought of reincarnation? That's the question. I don't fully agree that also without the concept reincarnation, you can come far with motivating people and children to become a good human being. But the concept of reincarnation does put the whole of society in a certain perspective. It does make you think that you become part of a bigger whole. So the awareness of reincarnation makes everything more understandable. Although without the concept, you can also come quite far. I'm glad you say that, and that also connects to what I have been trying to explain during my lecture. It is good as far as it goes, said Chi de Perucker. If you know more about incarnation, you know more, you understand more about the growth process. You see that also in educational systems, that you can talk about the inner man. But if you ask them, what do you mean by the inner man, they don't really understand what they mean with it. And if you better understand it, you can go further and deeper, if you understand it well. Maybe the danger is there that if you assume reincarnation, that you are more result oriented than you are not. It doesn't have to be a kind of reward. I'm very surprised about your answer, as if another view wouldn't be result oriented. And then I think the difference is enormous. When I try to attempt and to answer, of course, when I listen to this lady, I deep in my heart, I do know what has to happen, and from that ideals emanate. We all know that, and still we don't implement it. What the theosophy can offer is the knowledge, the underlying insight, why these people stick together in this way. Yeah, why it is so good to strive towards peace. when we in the West, from Christian and Islam starting point, would know more about reincarnation and karma, then many people, many problems would disappear. We would understand that everything that we do has effect, and that we also meet everyone again. Of course, we know that in education a lot of good things happen, because we know that this all should go like this. But we are lacking the underlying knowledge and insight. The knowledge of this would give much more keys to change things. It's essential to involve this reincarnation thought in it. In a child of two doesn't understand it, but that's why this sphere is so important. But for adults, it is quite essential to have this incorporated in your vision. Other reactions? I would like to extend it with re-embodiment, so that they also understand that it's also applies to the plants, minerals, animals. So a wider interpretation of reincarnation. I would like to come back to the second question of this gentleman. Reincarnation can also lead to degeneration. When this happens, when reincarnation is taken out of this context, it's not one jewel of wisdom, there are seven jewels of it. These are seven universal laws. It's an adventure to get to know them, and they relate to each other of the concept of unity. If you take it out and detach it from the concept of unity, then it becomes a distracted type of law. So if you detach it from the concept of unity, then it can be a distracted law. It's never only reincarnation, it's also always related to the other jewels of wisdom. If you study all those seven jewels, you never come to a degeneration of this.
What is now a little bit more clear for me is that if you talk about an education system that you aim for the higher elements, so so then you will notice more of unity and karma and reincarnation get out of this. So I think that Socrates has really looked into those, had gone into those questions and said, what's reincarnation? And in another 20 pages, he had asked himself, what is it, reincarnation? Then he had asked himself, what's good? And then he has got, how do you educate? And I think that integrating parts of society needs to be heard, so you would have had a better proposition if you had formulated in a Socratic, after Socratic process. I want to make a presentation, but correct me if I'm wrong. I think that Raja Yoga is, we have been discussing for 2 days about but I think that one of the basic elements, if Raja Yoga, correct me if I'm wrong, that you have also looked to look on the other side of the mirror. There are many and many families who have not those ILDs and have those circumstances which are not allowed them. So shouldn't we address also those kind of families? Answer: we postpone an ideal situation, and we hope that people will consider those ideas, and then it should could spread itself out. But a good citizen would also have respect for the opinion of others, and other people who do not believe in reincarnation, we could respect them, of course. But theosophists, the ethical understanding that everyone has its own conscience, on that we have a rationale for that, and I try to explain that. And every theosophical teaching is indeed has to do with, at the end, with compassion. And if the other people and if other people have also those ethical elements in them by nature, then they are even on a higher spiritual level. So there are many, many people who do know nothing about reincarnation, but live a life up to high ethical standards and do a magnificent job on education. But what we have is the rationale of why it is as it is. But the first line of my presentation was the way you act, the way you think, you is how you're acting. So if the boundlessness and the continuing and the unity of life is stands at first place and is your leading motive, then this will be exploited in all your acts. And then so the way you live your life is of major importance. We have now another proposition. The most wise people should educate their children. What do you think about that? An arm which almost touches the ceiling. Well, according to me, one of the that you also should give one of the weaker the opportunity to expand their possibilities. So if only the wisest should do the education, how then could other people learn how to educate? So, want to repeat, people should have an experience how to live the life and how to do things. Listen, no. I said not the absolute wisest, but wise people should do education and not the absolute wisest. Okay. You are completely wrong, but the most wisest should take on the education. So wise teachers are teaching children the school. But I've not been able to bring out one element that teachers should have love for their teaching and for their pupils and for teaching, and should have love for the parents. And what's a better teacher than a teacher who at the start of the season says to the parents of the children, may I have your email address? And then this teacher turns a group of parents into a special group and informs them about the subjects of learning. What would it be nice if you assisted me and your student with this subject, and because you now know what we are addressing, and that then you turn a group of people into a working group, get them involved in the educational system, and help them in doing homework and get them involved. Now these days, parents are used to do some reading and do recent lesson and help in traffic control, but they don't have any influence in the real education. So if they would help each other, then they would work all together on doing the homework. And so by doing so, I know from experience that children get better results, not meaning better grades, but having a better understanding. Is this something which people who work in education can do in their practice? So not only get the parents involved at the moment that the grades are insufficient, but get them involved right from the start as people who are a little bit less in teaching, but get them involved anyway. So this happens right now, says Barend, from his educational experience. in this there is an interesting point in the proposition. You should realize that you are a teacher towards those who are pupils, but on the other hand, you're a pupil yourself in relationship to wiser people. And second, the level of the teacher is not the most important, but the method and the key issues on which it is based. And some teachers are able and some are really unfit to do things. And a real teacher should be able and should know and stimulate and get everything out of the child, which is in the child. And how well equipped he is for that, that puts him somewhere in the overall structure. So, if you don't realize that they're not the right ones, and I shouldn't bring my pupils to such a teacher. Okay, other question? I'm willing to support this proposition, and it's not static, and not everyone is wise in the educational system. And if you consider a thing from a hierarchical perspective, then you have wiser people and a little bit and people who are a little bit unwise, but the wise people should pass knowledge along. And if you put this proposition in relationship to other, put the weaker in the forefront, because it's not static. So the less wise develop themselves continuously, also on the basis of the information they get from the wiser people on the wiser level. So if you get the information from the highest wise level, and the other ones who are a little bit on the weaker side, and they might. So they might then get an extra impulse. So you shouldn't. What do you mean by weaker students or weaker teachers? I think both. It addresses both. So if you think that a certain teacher has a certain helicopter view and overview, this. So I refer to what you mean. What was put forward on. As weaker in the earlier presentation, so people who are weaker might be leaded forward, and this helped them. So it's not an antithesis and an antithesis, but they are more in support of each other than that they are those two propositions contradictory. I'd like to react a little bit on who's the wisest. And then Socrates maybe addressed again. So it was said about Socrates that he was the wisest, and he said he was the wisest because he knew that he knew basically nothing as the only one, and that is often wrongly understood that he knew nothing at all. No, he realized that about the core values of things, he knew not everything or nothing. So a teacher who has the fire in him to be able to spread information, and he knows from himself that the fire in him, that there is additional knowledge to be gathered. And if you see it from such a perspective and from the perspective of compassion, then you know that as a teacher you have this function to pass on the knowledge. And then if you do something where other people, where you might be helpful to other people, then yes, you should indeed transfer what you are able to transfer to other people.
When I saw this proposition, it depends on the wise man should also be able to transfer it to other people. But if you have someone, in some cases, who is less wise but is paid able to transfer it, that would also an option. Sometimes you can think I'm even wiser than or smarter than I thought. So I think it depends on the situation. But I think it is good to pursue this situation, to have a wise who is also able to transfer it. If we talk about a wise person, then we also assume that he is able to transfer his wisdom and knowledge to someone else, to formulate it in a simple Buddhic, intuitive way. I'm a little bit in doubt. I think I don't understand the proposition because I think I don't agree. I hear that everybody agrees. I think that parents should educate children, and because they are placed there because of karmic consequences. And parents are not necessarily the most wise people that are there. Also for them, a process. I'm a little bit in doubt whether I understand the question. It is a collective approach. The parents have an obligation in this, and the teachers, but also at school. But the people who we put on the job as a professional, wisdom is not intellectual knowledge. Just if you are good in mathematics, you don't need to apply them. If you should be able to bring things over to a child from the point of insight. I think that the first place to educate people is the place where they come in the family with the parents, and they decide after that what for the children are the what the most appropriate education is suitable for them, which teachers, which people they meet. Can I react on this? You compare two things with each other. We have indicated here the most wise, the one with the biggest figures, and after that you talk about the parents. And you have parents that are wise and some are not wise, and you cannot compare those two things. If we talk about the most wise should educate the children, if you start with the parents, then you're it's clear that the parents should think that it is their mission to become the most wise, to educate the children. It's a challenge. If you the child as from karmic consequences was reincarnated at these parents, that gives responsibility to the parents. He suggests that some parents could also put their children out of house. But you were in my working group. I tasted a certain responsibility, and now from the several considerations you can decide what decision do you take. I can give you a small answer. One thing you should realize, karmically, you are not born 100% at these parents. You should always involve the six other jewels of wisdom in this context. Then you see that the parents are an element to that you can incarnate there. It's not 100% alone around these parents, but also the context around it. Also, sometimes you see that in the family, people play a very important role. And the children are lucky with other family members that can play an important role. It's not only 100% going back to these two parents. Most parents are so wise that they realize they are not so wise, so that they send their children to school and to the best school they think they can find. But some parents even conclude that they better keep them at home for their education. Is it maybe better to state that wisdom of the group?
Yeah.
And you have parents that, because of labor circumstances, cannot find too much time. So it's the wisdom of the group that is of importance. In fact, we are all wiser than the other one. And than all the people, and less wise than even higher developed people.
En degene ten opzichte van wie wij wijzer zijn, zouden wij, als we de principes goed zouden toepassen, moeten opvoeden.
Yeah, we should educate those who are less wise than we are, and we should follow those who are wiser than we are. And Madame Blavatsky says, search for those people who are less wise than you are and try to educate those people. It's all relative.
I've been studying this proposition, and a language has been given by the gods, and that the Dutch language is a superior language in the good sense of the and that wise in Dutch. And Blavatsky said wise people are the ones with the largest vision, and there is the word we in included. So I think this is very interesting that that in a language you find everything included, and that's why transferring those kind of wisdom very important. We are continuing to the next proposition. Proposition will be probably displayed. Jouw rebellion must be welcomed. I think that in a certain, from a certain perspective, this is okay, because children react in a certain way, and they want to bring something from the inside into the open, and yes, that gives a certain rebellious reaction. Very short. If not, there wouldn't be any interesting life in the sense of being a lively situation in the family. I think that this proposition is, I can agree this, because if not, that if there would not be any rebellion of the house, then this would mean that there wouldn't be any consciousness and self, and that they would accept everything and wouldn't do any thinking of their own, and this is the last thing that we would like to have. Okay, your children are already a little bit older, so you have this experience, already had this experience. So, are there any reaction from our German friends? Da gibt's keine Probleme. There are no problems in Germany.
No, I think we can learn quite a lot from the youth who is rebelling, because how can you change? Well, we normally act according to our used patterns of behavior, and the youth is giving us a kind of mirror. So we can see where we could maybe change some of our of the things which we are always used to, and we don't really see them anymore. So in that respect, I would say to come to a betterment of our own understanding, it is to be welcomed.
But We also heard that we have to consider if the rebellion is acceptable or not. We heard that, I think, in the puberty lecture, that we have to consider if a reaction of the youth is acceptable or not. So that depends on how grave that is.
Jos, vertaal het even.
Zo. Vertalen, ja, ja, dat is een goede. Ja, ja, daar zijn we twee dagen mee bezig, ja. De laatste bijdrage die werd. Of zijn er eigenlijk mensen die dit niet begrepen hebben?
Hey, vertalen, ja, kom op.
Voordat ik dit
kom,
allemaal vertalen. Ga. Alleen Barend? Voor de mensen thuis. Maar ik denk dat het erover ging, zoals ik het begrepen heb, opstand, rebellion. He, dat begrijpen we wel, maar tot zekere grenzen. He? Tot. You have no translation. So now I have to do it in English or in German again. So exactly your words were, for a rebellion from young people, that's acceptable until certain limits. Okay, yes, that was I think in the presentation, of course, if it ends up in you know, in such a kind of behavior that there will be victims, okay, you have to try and avoid that or prevent that. Thank you very much. Und jetzt auf Deutsch.
Okay. Nog andere reacties op deze stelling? Ik denk dat we.
Are there any other reactions on this proposition? I think that we can indeed differentiate in what form you can be plainly against something or find out that you're put in a certain framework, but on the other hand, some alternatives might be much more interesting. So that's the main difference. Are you forced or have you a free choice? I want to change it in a little bit and made it more challenging and saying a good education makes youth rebellious. So if you, and we think that we always know better than the children, and in the end we do realize that we know less, and that gives a little bit of room for us, and that's also for us a learning experience. So you might indeed do better than to give second thought in this reaction of the youth. What's the background of it and why is it caused?
Jenny, achter je.
Whitney Houston.
I believe that children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way.
But if we would do that, then this rebellion is not necessary anymore if you follow those lyrics of Whitney Houston. So it's caused the rebellion because every human being and also the children has indeed two windows, and the one shows how the situation should be and the other shows what the reality is, and it's a saying of Gandhi, and if you don't have the means and the rest in your own being to see those two elements, then you need to experience both sides of this duality to come to a better understanding. So we should try to find out if this rebellion indeed leads to something, to wisdom or not. So one of the touchstones here is impersonal, and what's working here? It's about the ego of the puber, and it's selfishness was driving him. Or it has to do with an impersonal aspect. Does it have, for instance, to do with the situation that we in Europe are not able to give comfort to fugitives? Then I see that offends me also. My daughters, for instance, couldn't understand that we, with 400 million people in Europe, are not able to give a comfortable home to smaller numbers of fugitives. We should be able to solve this problem with each other, and this, people can't understand that this is not the case. May I reassess Jos's presentation? He said idealism deploys itself in the puberty, and we have this experience of couples here with children in puberty, so they're getting very critical against their parents if they come with their the underdeveloped idealism against their not completely developed idealism to their parents, and they're sitting on their couch potatoes for the television, and they have made a very simple thing of their life, and they're going once again to the Blavatsky house, but they are not rebellious, they're doing something else, but they respect that. So in a certain situation where the parents don't give enough content to a life, then the pubers become critical, and they're saying, hey, they are putting questions then about their own life if the example is wrong. Okay, we still have a last proposition here.
We are afraid that coming period you have nothing to do, so we have a last proposition. The age we are thinking about is still the age of 99, so time and much time ahead. What do you think? Can we continue to learn till the day we die? Till our last breath? Yeah, you have a problem if you say no. There is something double in this. Learning can mean... By learning at a certain number of levels, you are dying. But also means if you get new insight, is it most of the time a replacer of something that is more limited, so you are born at another level as well. Is learning not all at the same time doing research, investigation? We found this already quite a challenge, that you can learn till the last breath. There's another consequence connected to this. You can say to yourself, you can learn till you die, but as society, you can come to the conclusion that those older people, when they are 65, we don't need to discard them. In the later years, when a lot of wisdom can be harvested, we can put them at jobs that they are can be used for. 67? I think longer. By the time Bauke is 67, there will be no retirement anymore. Especially when all people have followed the symposium. We would like to give you another thought with you. Theosophia is the best teacher for young and old. If you can, until September, you can ponder on this thought. That's a nice thing for the summer time. The table is open Everything is put on video of this symposium, and you can also watch it back on internet, this videos, so you have things to think about. Last thing, as a memory I want to give to you, is the upcoming activities, International Theosophical Conference in The Hague. It's an organization who tries to bring different, bring into contact different theosophical organizations. It's from 6th to 9th of August, very nearby here in the Carlton Ambassador Hotel. 6th September, the Blavatska is open with the open day on Sunday 6th September. For everyone who's interested can come and see us and to hear what's on next season. And in early 2016, we start up with once a month a lecture in English. And in September we start with our lectures in the various cities in Holland. The course Thinking Differently starts in October, and our course Life Wisdom also starts in October. So we will be very active next season. For our all our members comes a number of other activities in the summer in international platforms. We thank you very much for your presence and your contributions during the last 2 days, and also the application of the thoughts that we studied. Thank you very much, and goodbye. If you want to support us also financially, you will find at the exit a basket where you can drop a contribution. Thank you very much.
Hartelijk dank en tot ziens.